Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Brookfield Board of Selectmen's meeting for Tuesday, April 11th. Ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much. I will entertain a motion to approve the payroll warrant. Correction for 329, expense warrant for 44, payroll warrant for 411, and expense warrant for 411.
I will make that motion.
Second. Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Entertain a motion to acknowledge the minutes and monthly reports of the Personnel Board for January 10th, 17th, 24th, and the EMS monthly reports for 317, and Fire monthly report for 317.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Announcements. The Memorial Day Parade will take place Monday, May 29th. Fellow citizens, veterans, first responders, scouts, students, and more are invited to join in a proper observance of the day. Parade starts at 10 a.m. at the Brookfield Elementary School, continues to the Brookfield Cemetery at 10:30, to the Town Common Memorial Square at 11:30, and in case of rain, assembly will be held at the Brookfield Elementary School cafeteria. The Brookfield Planning Board seeks a part-time assistant administrative clerk. Job description is posted on the Town of Brookfield Facebook page at www.facebook.com/brookfield.ma. That's a lot of dots and letters, huh? At the Brookfield Post Office at the Town Hall from the Town Clerk, interested candidates should send a letter of interest, resume, and salary requirements to the Brookfield Planning Board, 6 Central Street, Brookfield, Mass., 01506, or S. Mahoney, that'd be S-M-A-H-O-N-E-Y, at brookfieldma.us. Application deadline is 3 p.m. on Thursday, April 27th. Any other announcements? Hearing none, anybody wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
I guess I'll be the only person to come up.
First question, who set the town meeting? Are you going to just change, you're going to change the town meeting, right?
That's the only reason why we're here tonight.
The only reason?
We didn't have a scheduled meeting.
How can you even set a meeting at 9:30 in the morning?
I didn't know what time it was, but I'm not opposed to it. I'm up at
no, that's not my
5 a.m., so...
9:30 in the morning on a Saturday.
Regardless. I mean,
how can you even come up with that time? Who came...
We thought it was a good time. We'd have the annual at 10.
Well, you don't want no one to show up. I wasn't going
to
show up.
No, the desire is to show up. So, do you want to still have it on? No, okay.
No, I mean,
anything else, Dave?
Yeah, don't start laughing, because you're going to do
I'm laughing
for me, too.
I'm laughing, Dave.
I'm still eating my Cheerios, for crying out loud.
All right. Switch to Frosted Flakes.
No, I like the Cheerios. What was else I going to say? That's just too much. That really is. Okay, budget. We got the clerk down at the highway over, when we're doing the budget, we're over 160 hours in that budget. How can we let something like this happen? We're 160 hours over budget, approximately. We don't know exactly how much it is yet, but that's about 2 months of her time based on 20 hours a week.
She's over the budget.
Yes. I mean, who's watching the store here?
Every time we question, and you've questioned it here, it's always a response of working with the bridge. I don't see how 100
hours. Oh, I understand. Yeah, I understand the Dunbar. That's what they said, but I mean, 160 hours working on the Dunbar Bridge. I mean,
well,
come on.
She's put a lot of hours in. I know she also writes a lot of grants also.
No, no, I understand, but the grants are part of the 20 hours, not the extra
yeah,
work.
But a lot of times, though, Dave, if you're writing grants for different things, that takes away from your regular job that you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
And she still has to do that. I mean, I'm just saying that experience from working, you know, here. That's what I'm saying.
No, I know, but we boosted her up from back in the day another 10 hours to 2 grants, which is good for the town, and we discussed that, and we don't have any problem with that. But when you're over 160 hours in a budget, what's the sense of us even doing budgets if we're going to go over that much? I mean, that's like Karen. She's got different problems every day. What's that mean? She's going to go over every week. She's going to go over another, you know, and at the end of the, she's going to be over 2-3 months. Because she's got new problems coming in every day, and other departments
so
the same thing.
So did you ask that department head, which would be her, the same question?
Yeah, they said Dunbrook Bridge. We just took data that night. We went, you know, analyzing it. Well, we're gonna go back and discuss it with them once, you know. I mean, are you the liaison down there?
Not officially. I do a lot of liaisoning, but
okay. Well, no. Maybe you can. Yeah, just I mean, I'm just saying we can't. We got to stay in budget, is what I'm saying.
I didn't think it was over that. You're positive it's over that?
I didn't think it was that far.
Yeah, it's about.
So Clarence,
around about 2 months.
Can you just look into the hours there? Thank you.
I will.
We're waiting to see. We don't know exactly because we got the ledgers were a couple weeks behind, you know. But that's what they thought too. They thought we might be behind. I thought we went behind, but then I checked after the meeting, and we're behind.
And the only thing I would offer is that I've been going back and forth with Cindy on grants and grant writing, and our open space plan is overdue. We're delinquent after December of 2016, and we have to do that to be in position for grants. So I do know that she's been trying to work on that to try to get that to get us to a position where we wouldn't be in jeopardy of applying for grants. So that is something certainly in the next month or so that we're going to have to face into. And it's going to take a concerted effort to get that thing done so that we don't lose sight of the grant monies available.
Oh, we don't want to lose sight of that, no. No, I'm not saying that. I'm just trying to stay, and there's other few other departments too.
Clarence will report back to us.
Yeah, if we can. I'm just trying to keep it in budget, you know.
Okay.
While I'm here, public access discussion while I'm sitting right here, what's that about?
We'll take it up under number one.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, then I'm all done. Thank you.
All right, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Anybody else wish to address the board this evening?
Yeah, I have a question for the board.
You mind coming up? So the camera and microphone can pick you up, sir. Welcome.
Since when does the town just go out and buy vehicles without things going out for bid?
In regards to?
The police cruiser, the new fire chief's cruiser. Did it go to bid? And who were the other two bidders?
The police cruiser and the fire vehicle was stated that it's a state bid at the dealer.
I thought it was a municipality had to have things go out to bid.
From what I was told by the police chief, at the place that they got it and the fire chief got it from the same individual, that it was a state bid company right there.
Yeah. It's what they call come by. Seems how I'm getting smarter and smarter about financial policies of late. It's the program is called a come by. It's something new where the state goes out and negotiates the best price, and then you basically get to buy from that.
I don't know. I'm disappointed in the board. I think you people have lost total control of the town. The money going out is astronomical. Look at the taxes. And I think you can do a better job watching our pennies because it's out of hand. I don't know if you remember Bob Wilder, but he and I were both told, if you can't afford taxes in town, I guess you got to move. Well, that's a hell of a thing for an assessor to tell.
Never come out of this board's mouth.
No, not out of this board, no. But it was told by a town employee.
I just don't think it's right. I've worked every day since I've been elected to public office back in, I think, in 05. School committee, biggest budget in town. I've worked every day to make our lives easier financially. I had an individual call me about 2 weeks ago when he found I wasn't running again and said I had an agenda, which took me aback because I didn't think I ever had an agenda. But he said my agenda was to save taxpayers' money. And that made me feel good.
I think you should run again.
I think
we're going to be in a lot of trouble, in my opinion. We got too many liberals in town.
I don't have the time, my friend.
Huh?
I don't have the time, unfortunately.
Well, you don't need the headache either, I understand.
It's not about... I enjoy this. This is it's not even a job to me. This is something I enjoy immensely.
Yeah.
I love working for this town. I'm literally building two houses right now. I have a driving school with three locations. I need more help. Anybody wants to come work, love to have you. But I'm wearing five different hats in two different businesses.
Okay.
I can't do it.
I would give you also just one other thought. Speaking of, because you brought up the subject of houses, we now have two houses in my neighborhood that are going up. You have your houses that are going up. I understand that there are nine houses going up. And my statement with respect to that is I pray that there are no children in those houses.
Well, mine's a duplex with two bedrooms, so... Guaranteed.
But one of the struggles, and again, I appreciate your comments, one of the struggles that we have is that we really don't have a tax base. And when we start building houses and throw kids in school, that's a real whack.
Well, we ought to stop spending money. I mean, it's going out like, it's unbelievable.
Well, we have to encourage to try to get some more businesses here in this town.
You're not going to get them in here with the tax rate and no sewerage. Now, let's face it, it's a dead town. It's dying. Look at everything that's left since you've been around town. It's done. Your people have taxed us right out of...
Right out of the town.
Thank you, sir. Want to say something, Dave? Hopefully something a little bit more uplifting than that.
No, I just wanted...
Beat up on us again?
I never beat up on you. I just state the facts.
Right.
When can I get the stair guy in here for the...
Whenever. We were waiting for you.
Okay, so how about the next agenda?
I would only ask, have you chatted with Bill Simpson?
I have.
Okay.
And he's talking to somebody for me to make sure the ADA is, and I'm talking to my guy and I'm trying to get him in here, so.
That's cool.
When's your next meeting, the 20th?
The 18th.
18th, okay.
I don't think we have time on that agenda, though. I think we'll have to wait till May.
Oh, really? It's going to be that big? When are you meeting with the advisory board, too, now that I'm sitting here?
Mm-hmm. We set the date, well, tentative. You guys haven't, I don't have a calendar in front of me.
May 9th, we said.
That was the first May mm-hmm. date.
Okay, we should be ready, I think. Okay.
How is the budget coming along now that you're here?
In what areas, when you say how's it coming?
No, is it coming, I mean, are people level funding their budgets, or are they going over their budgets? Or?
Both. Some people want to get 100% increase in their pay. We can't do that. They want to double it, 100%, whatever you want to call it.
That's 100% if they double them.
Yeah. So, we're fighting like hell, but we're making a lot of friends in here, Linda. No, but we got to see the police department's lagging because of the contracts. You guys working with the chief? You almost done with the chief?
We just started negotiation.
Okay. And how about the patrolman? Who's
we're going to talk about that. I spoke with the sergeant. Now that I'm not going to run again, he hasn't contacted me. I spoke with him. He was going to get back to me. That's on the agenda.
See, we can't do that budget either, you know. So that's that one. What's going on with the treasurer? Is she back, or is she going to be able to?
I have cross your fingers.
We're going to discuss that either the 18th or May 9th.
Well, I mean, I got to get a budget way before then.
Yeah, we'll get you the budget.
Well, you just scared me. You just said May 10th.
Well, no, in regards to her status, we'll know that the worst, latest date is May 9th. We'll be able to discuss in the meeting.
Okay, but
budget-wise, Karen...
Budget is what I'm interested in.
Can you make sure that budget gets over? Yeah. It shouldn't be anything complicated.
Okay.
We can talk then.
So we got that one, the tax collector, and the police, pretty much, and then we're going to do a recap on a couple and put it together, and then
You'll be ready.
Oh, I hope so.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, guys and ladies.
Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Item number one, public access discussion. Mr. Snyder had sent an email. The floor is yours, sir.
I had a concern from our last meeting when we were talking about elected and appointed officials that we need to be cautious if we're going to be talking about character and the like, and that if things go down that path, that we need to be cautious that town employees, elected appointed officials need to be forewarned, and I believe and understand that warning should be at least 48 hours in advance of the meeting. And so it was more caution that we need to be careful going forward.
So, Linda, did you want this? Karen's whispering my ear that you
Oh, I do have. I have that right. It's the same plan. Big clip. All right. Karen and I did a survey.
Oh, okay.
Because survey? Or with STAN members.
All the STAN members. So that
dozens of replies.
Dozens of replies we've got.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Some of them do hold a period for public access at the beginning of the meeting. And discussion is managed by the chair. Some individuals are restricted to 3 to 5 minutes and not to exceed 15.
Some towns restrict.
Some towns.
Okay. Yeah.
And then also, they said that the Board of Selectmen is not taking any action on votes during the session, which we've never done. Some towns prohibit controversial subjects. And now, the town of West Brookfield, I know we had talked to her, and she said if you want during public access, they really don't have one. If you want to be on the agenda, you have to call them that Friday before the meeting.
So remember so 2 weeks ago when I begged both of you to continue public access, not to time it?
Oh, you did.
I know you did. But the only thing, my main concern is, I mean, I just don't like what's been happening around here with the accusations that are going on with people's characters. You know, this has got to stop. It shouldn't be happening during public access.
Or that the individuals need to be present.
Yeah, and they need to be present. And then some towns, like the town in North Brookfield, we found out, they only have, like, at the end of their meeting, it's like a 2-minute public access of what they do.
I sat out there and I watched the prior boards, and I sat here for a year as a selectman and watched that board censor citizens that pay the taxes in this town, that pay the $2,000 that we get for a year. And you can hear the anger in my voice. It's unacceptable to me.
And I don't think anyone's disagreeing.
You can see number two, it's at the discretion of the chair. I don't think anybody brought anybody's character to a point that it was really actionable.
And I only said concern. I didn't say
I was just concerned. I just didn't like what happened a couple of weeks ago. I had missed the other meeting, and I just don't think personal attacks should be carried on.
Personal attacks? I got slammed.
I didn't see you.
But it is what it is. That gentleman lives in town. He pays taxes in town.
Yep.
He has the right to accuse me of whatever he wants to accuse him of. And just like Clarence, if I want to pursue it in a civil court, I can pursue it in a civil court.
Sure.
But we just did what I just had Karen. We just did this to get an opinion of what they do in the other communities. That's all.
I did it here for a year. They did it for a few more years because of one person in town. That's censorship.
Yeah, and again, my thought was not censorship. My thought was that because of character, there are certain obligations that we have as a board, and so we just need to be cautious.
That's at the discretion of the chair.
And got it.
All right.
Thank you.
Any other conversation? Item number two. I signed the MIIA insurance rate because it was due, so I'm going to request a ratification of said signature.
I will make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Mr. Snyder put together item number three, personal safety equipment policy, a policy very straightforward. The purpose of the personal protection equipment policy is to protect the employees of Brookfield from exposure to workplace hazards and the risk of injury through the use of personal protective equipment, PPE. PPE is not a substitute for more effective control methods, and its use will be considered only when other means of protection against hazards are not adequate or feasible. It will be used in conjunction with other controls unless no other means of hazard control exists. Personal protective equipment will be provided, used, and maintained when it has been determined that that its use is required to ensure the safety of health of our employees and that such use will lessen the likelihood of occupational injury and or illness. Town departments are responsible to adopt specific instructions relating to their activities. So I'm going to entertain a motion to approve this as a policy and to forward it to all department heads.
Could I?
I'm sorry.
So,
well, this was an email a few weeks ago.
Yes.
Okay, so. Well, I had it. It's just not my fault.
So just to go just a touch further, that this could be the beginning of a larger set of work instructions related to certain activities that are most common.
But definitely. But the caveat to this whole thing is that it sets the town up for protection.
That we're in favor of it.
If insurance comes down on us, we have a policy in place and we are cognizant of it.
Yep. That was a good suggestion and hopefully.
So I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item number four. Before we take wage authorizations, I'm going to have to do a little cleaning. There is a request in here for a second operator, but before we bring that on and appoint, we have to accept the resignation that we've never accepted from the previous second operator. So I'm going to entertain a motion to accept with regret Mr. Herbert's resignation as the secondary water operator.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussions?
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
There's a member of the Water Commission, could I speak?
Yep.
Don has been a secondary operator. You know, he's a town employee. He also works as a secondary operator for the water department. We also use other secondary operators, and we have in the past. We can't get coordination with them at this time. We've reached out to North Brookfield. We've reached out to West Brookfield. We have reached out to East Brookfield. The two in East Brookfield are retiring, so they have requested that they not be on-call operators any longer. So if Don is still an employee and still willing to be an on-call operator, that gives us some flexibility.
So are you requesting us not to accept his resignation?
What I would suggest is that it's a good policy, as far as the water department is concerned, to have somebody in that position as a training option. Right now we have one superintendent, and when we need a secondary operator on a weekend or a holiday, we have to reach out to somebody else who's licensed and certified as an operator. Unfortunately, that pool of people is dwindling, and it's dwindling at an alarming rate. East Brookfield's having a real problem trying to find a superintendent, just like we were fortunate in getting a superintendent in Brookfield. The applicants are down, and the people that are willing and able and certified and trained to act as these operators is very small. If you have an employee in town who is willing to be an operator in training, he can work under the superintendent's license as an on-call operator. And in that way, if you have a superintendent leave, you have somebody else who is already a town employee who is in kind of the network, learning the nuances of your system. I'm sorry to hear that Donald is
Well, this was dated January 1st, 2017.
Okay.
And this was brought actually into the office today by James.
I know that Donald doesn't work weekends, and he generally gave the superintendent coverage when he needed it. So he's not on call. I mean, he doesn't provide a service on a regular basis.
Has he been working?
He hasn't. A matter of fact, our superintendent, since the day he was hired, hasn't had a day off because we have no other operators. So this is the reason that we're trying to get wage authorizations for on-call operators. One of the other options is because this field of applicants or a field of people that are ready, willing, able, and licensed to do this job is so small, we have reached out to two contractors and asked them. We've had one that has come in and done an inspection of the system and is submitting us a proposal. It's not going to be cheap. I mean, as we talk now, our proposal for an on-call operator is in pretty much in line with what it has been for a number of years. As a subcontractor, it's not going to be as cheap as what we're getting. The way it's structured now, the water department pays, if we can find one, like we had in the past, we pay for on-call service, and it costs you about $80 a day.
And that's with a contract?
No, that is that.
What we're paying.
That's what we are paying now. I don't know what it will be.
Double
that. The contractor will probably double that.
Exactly.
I would guess that's probably the case.
This wage authorization, the new one, is for $21 an hour. So that's not even close to $80 a day.
Well, here's how it's structured. $21 an on-call operator is on call for 24 hours. So the on-call operator will get paid 1 hour's pay for eight hours of work, of being on call. So that's times three is the 24 hours. And then there's a $21 upfront cost for transportation, being here, and so it ends up being $84 a day. So that's how that is structured.
All right, so do you want us not to accept Donnie's?
I don't know if Donald will continue to work. I know that he has reservations about working weekends, and he doesn't want to do it on a regular basis, but it does give us some flexibility. If we get into a bind, he has always said he's willing to help.
So are you willing to withdraw the motion?
I will withdraw the motion.
Okay. And having two second operators is the best policy for your department?
Actually, having more than two was the best policy. We thought we had another person from out of town who's certified and qualified. We were advised that he probably wouldn't be a good choice for town. Yeah. So, I mean, we want somebody that's qualified and makes smart mm-hmm. choices. Thank and you. This particular case, it wasn't a good fit.
All right. So I'll entertain a motion to appoint and accept the wage authorization for Mr. Clark as a second operator at a rate of $21 an hour.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
But this does point to the larger issue of available resources, and it's not going to get easier.
I will entertain a motion to approve the wage authorizations for Mr. Leahy, Mr. Siri, and Mr. Wasmer for Title V for $15.53, and the same individuals for health agent administration for the same rate.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
And we discussed the budget. It's in the budget.
Yes, I discussed it with them.
So all in favor?
Aye.
To our desire to hold a town meeting on Saturday. Took it from every side. Heard it again today.
Yep.
So we're here to set a new date. I'd almost argue that we need to change the bylaw. We either follow the bylaw or get rid of it or change it, one of the three. So that might be something worth discussing as well in regards to articles.
Well, we haven't been following the bylaw because it's been if we did follow the bylaw, it would be the Friday after the election.
We'd have to have it on the 5th of May, which obviously
and
not.
And we haven't been following it because, you know, all the figures from the state haven't been coming in.
Yeah.
I thought maybe Saturday, I mean, everybody's been complaining we have it on a Friday night. So that's when he thought we'd change it to a different day, because like Clarence had said, when he lived in Westminster, they did.
Wait, yeah, we had the discussion, but everybody's blocking, so we're done.
So we're done.
So let's stay with the Friday night, because at least the town voted to have us as a bylaw a Friday night.
Yep.
So you want to do Friday, June 9th?
Yes. Yeah. Do the change.
You want to do what? Linda, what do we usually do? 6:30? 5:30, 6?
The annual is normally at 7, so we can have so a 6:30. Special at 6:30.
So with the special at 6:30 and the regular at 7,
yeah.
Dates will not change for submittal of articles because we do need to get them to town council. We're actually losing a day, but we're good there. So I'll entertain a motion to set a new date for the annual town meeting and special town meeting to June 9th, 2017. 6:30 p.m. for special town, 7 for annual.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Discussion.
Is the school going to be available then?
Yeah, it always is.
All in favor?
Aye.
We have an individual that is putting his best foot forward in regards to assistant animal control officer, so I'll entertain a motion to approve Mr.
Polakowski.
Thank you very much. I was just going to call me Anthony. As our assistant administrative, we're going to replace Karen, animal control officer with a term to expire June 30th.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Fortunately.
All in favor?
Aye.
Item number 7, there is a request to hold a tractor parade on May 27th. Bylaw states that the Board of Selectmen have to approve it. In conjunction with the Gardens Club plant sale on the Common, the route would travel Common Street, Central, River, and Lincoln. Spoken with the chief, and he has given his okay. I will entertain a motion to allow the Agricultural Commission to hold such event.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Number 8, I will no longer be serving. I did discuss with the sergeant at a last meeting that he had to meet with his individual and set the ground terms and get back to me. He hasn't done so. We can reach out to him and either say I can keep going with it, do what we have to do, get through one or two rounds, or we can just table it until we appoint a new person, or we can appoint a new person here now. One of three.
No, I can't do it because I'm already on for the school.
I've got, for the next 3 weeks, I'm busy with...
Do you want me to reach out? And this is just conversation for the board. Do you want me to reach out and ask him what he wants to do?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've got 3 weeks before I can really do much of anything.
At a request of a citizen, these executive session minutes have been approved by the board, but not released. Individual... In regards to this, is requesting that we release them, so I'm going to entertain a motion to release executive session minutes of 10-18-16.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second that.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All right, there is no other, unless you guys have other.
Oh, I do have another.
Another other?
Another other. Back to a complaint on Sunday related to the racetrack. So I called I'll get it in a minute. But anyway, Dan, whatever the guy's name. Plurin. And said that I had received a complaint and that my advice to that neighbor was that if it was 85 dBA or greater at the property line, that in fact that they should call the environmental police because they have responsibility to act if that there is a noise complaint. And what I explained to them is that the machine themselves should be no louder than 85 dBA at 3 feet. So if you got a motocross bike and you're standing 3 feet away and you have a decibel meter, that should read 85 or less. And so I informed him that he needed to be very cautious as to what was going on, because as it was explained to me in the call, is that for a period of time the noise was okay, and I'll just use that term, and then all of a sudden it escalated. And my concern there is that he had a bike or bikes that were not compliant with noise. And again, I forewarned
was
him.
Was a request sent to that complainant to call the state?
That's what I did. I said,
is the state working with residents or?
No. That was the first call, first time it happened.
Can you reach out to Donnie or Ann?
I'm sorry?
State rep or state
senator? Oh, I would. I can certainly forewarn him. Absolutely.
Well, can you reach out to either of them and ask them to pursue the state?
Yeah. Because again, it's. If you have a measurement at the property line that is 85 dBA, it says it's a whole lot noisier inside and that you shouldn't be subjected to that kind of noise. Unfortunately, what the noise level is on a typical country road is about 40 dBA.
It's a tough situation. I grew up riding dirt bikes. I'm an advocate of racing, proponent of it. I think it keeps kids safe in a controlled environment as opposed to on the street doing stuff that's bad. But you do have to take into account residents around, and we do have laws and regulations regarding it, so the town's really not set up to regulate that. We do have regulations through the state, so it should be regulated on that level.
Right.
So if Ann or Steve, I don't know, I keep saying Steve,
Donnie can help out with that. I think that's a good
point. Just to
we heard it. It came through. We had the windows down. We could hear it the state coming. Yeah. So you said to go to the property line. We just go out on the driveway.
What did you have for a reading?
We didn't do it this time. We will though this weekend because I'm sure it's going to be loud.
No, it only.
But there's nothing a resident can do just sitting there. You're telling the Board of Selectmen is not going to do anything.
It's not, no. The call was, I shouldn't say pleasant, but the call was matter of fact as far as what could and couldn't be done, where the town's position is with respect to the racetrack, that he is allowed to have that operation as a practice track, and that's what the court's decided.
All right. And you're going to follow up with?
I will follow up with Don.
All right. Notice from the state DOT, Mass DOT, Chapter 90 has been approved at 163,720. Bridge inspection report was submitted to the Highway Superintendent. He is aware of it. Charter lineup has changed their lineup. Well, Charter Communications has changed their lineup effective on or after April 25th, 2017. WGGB Channel 15 will no longer be available in areas outside of the station's television market, which includes those systems in the Charlton, Leicester, Rutland, Southbridge, and Webster Channel lineups. I don't think it applies. Item number four, the school superintendent is letting us know as a community that the school committee on the Tantasqua side has implemented three policies, a drug-free workplace, teaching about alcohol, tobacco, and drugs, and JICH, alcohol, tobacco, and drug use by students. So those three policies have been added, and they are available for viewing on the policy manual, which I believe is online. On the school's website. DEP has reached out to us letting us know that the SMRP municipal grant application is June 14th and they must be submitted online. And I would ask that we forward this to the appropriate departments. Any other discussions, matters, issues this evening? Hearing none, I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
I will make that motion.
And I'll second it.
Discussion, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, everybody.